So there have been many pilots in terms of attempting to sort of incorporate value into care delivery, which of course I would define as better aligning the way care is provided with the payment system. To answer the question, I don't think we've really gotten to scale yet. I think these have remained pilots. I think there are probably the scale that's happened has happened within organizations, scaling across organizations, so taking programs that they've done and branching them out into multiple ambulatory clinics or other kind of acute care hospitals or integrating across their system. I think less so, broadly speaking, across the market. Or across the country. You know, that's not to say that there aren't some examples, but I think one of the big barriers, frankly, is that, and as was talked about at this meeting, is that we're still largely in a discounted fee-for-service-based payment arrangement. So there really isn't the incentive to scale these things, as much as maybe some people had hoped. I think a lot of the organizations that are doing work in this, the delivery systems that are doing work, are ones that are making a bet, forward thinking that this is the way the payment landscape is really going to go, and that it's worth kind of going down this path. In fact, I've talked to some who have said, we know what we're doing is losing money, or at least not covering the investment that we're making, but we believe that it's worth kind of getting experience with these programs now, these pilots now, because it will pay off in the future. So. Again, to go back to the question, I don't think we've had nearly the level of scale that was envisioned by CMS, by many others, as we talk about kind of expectations for value-based payment models. So it's sort of that it's that thing that everybody seems to be involved in, but it hasn't grown quite at the rate that we expected it to be.